we started looking at the city the same way. If we had a broken block, how can we take the best parts of all of the city and put it into one place to get it kickstarted, urban defibrillate that place, make it alive again?
That was the question a few months back, posed by Andrew Howard, part of Team Better Block, a Texas-based company with a knack for re-beautifying cities one block at a time, quickly, with little money, and a lot of volunteer help. Enter that volunteer help. These were just a few of the hundreds of Norfolk residents and volunteers who took part in the first ever Norfolk Better Block.
I could sum it up, it would be a temporary makeover to sort of demonstrate the kind of city, what the kind of city we want to live in looks like.
The theme for this Better Block, an arts district.
I'm originally from New York, and you can imagine up there, it's a melting pot of different people, cultures, everything. So I mean, the fact that they're trying to bring that mixture or that diversity to this area and to brighten it up, I think it's wonderful.
The week-long makeover took place on Granby Street between Olney Road and Addison Street. Once nicknamed Auto Row, it used to be a thriving section of Granby Street full of auto dealerships and people. But more recently, it could be described as
derelict,
deserted.
Where are all the businesses? Where's all the life?
All the life showed up at the end of the Better Block Build-A-Thon, which was the whole point. Temporarily spice up the block, get people there,
hi, how are you?
And show them all the possibilities and potential that are available for this block, and really any block in Norfolk.
In my eyes, it's a walkable, vibrant, artistic, friendly community.
I actually work here at CoLab, one of the members, and had a shop down here for a while, 540 Design, and so I was in this space for about 3 years, and it was pretty dead down here. So, I mean, just in 2 days to see this many people suddenly using the space and enjoying the street and kind of valuing it, it's pretty incredible.
The weekend celebration was filled with street vendors.
Don, hey, there's two beef.
Cafes, and of course, fun.
You know, when you go into this, we get a lot of questions, what's going to be like, and it is an act of improv, and we know if we gather the right folks together that something great's going to come out of it. So I'd actually rank this in the top five of across the whole country. We've done about 48, 50 of these now, and Norfolk really came out.
It all ties back into Norfolk's philosophy of neighbors building neighborhoods.
This is essentially a reflection of us, so why not have us do it? You know what I mean? If it's going to be something that we're going to appreciate or have around, you know, it tells a story. What are we doing?
This is what the residents of Norfolk are doing, putting their minds together, trying to better their city one block at a time. And even though it was great, all of this was only temporary. So what's next?
Norfolk's got about 30 days here to capture this momentum. The cities are going to have to be nimble and quick about making things like this permanent. A lot of ordinances being broken that need to be, that are left over from 30s and 40s age. And so we've got a short period of time to catch this momentum and make it legal and give the incentives here to make it permanent.
I hope that everything that's done here is supported so that it can stay here. And the model that's applied to this block during this weekend is applied, maybe not the rest of the city, but large parts of it.
For Norfolk News Now, I'm John Linka.